I am Roberto Bolli from the University of Louisville. I'm a speaker at the 2014 meeting of the Basic Cardiovascular Sciences Council. My talk is scheduled on Thursday morning, and it's entitled Advances and Lessons Learned from Clinical Trials with Stem Cells. The main point of my presentation will be to discuss where we are with clinical investigation of cell therapy and where we should go. There has been a lot of concern lately regarding the efficacy of cell therapy, and some have even gone as far as questioning whether clinical trials of stem cells should continue. I think that it is very important to rely on data and not on personal or subjective opinions of individual investigators. So let's look at the data achieved so far. Stem cell therapy is a very recent field of investigation. For practical purposes, clinical trials started roughly 10 years ago. There have been numerous studies of different types of stem cells in patients with cardiovascular disease, particularly in patients with acute myocardial infarction and with heart failure. Most of these studies have been relatively small studies, phase one or phase two trials, with a limited number of subjects, and that is expected in a new field that is just starting. So just because the trials have been small does not mean that the results are not meaningful or significant. This is the initial necessary phase of any field of clinical investigation. The best way to interpret these small studies is by looking at meta-analysis of the data that have been conducted so far. So instead of expressing opinions regarding a certain type of cell or whether a certain type of study should go on, we should look at the evidence, and the best evidence we have are the results of meta-analysis of studies conducted heretofore. There was a recent meta-analysis published in 2014 in the European Heart Journal by Delevi and colleagues that examined all clinical trials that were done in patients with an ST elevation myocardial infarction or STEMI. So the total number of subjects is actually quite large, more than 1,600 patients. And he reviewed a total of 16 studies. And the conclusion of this meta-analysis was that in the aggregate, there is a significant improvement in left ventricular ejection fraction of approximately 3%, as well as a reduction in left ventricular end-systolic volume. This is a large number of subjects. And certainly, although the data are clearly not conclusive, this kind of data support continuing further investigations in this patient population. It should be pointed out that there were also no significant adverse effects in these trials that could be ascribed to cell therapy. Perhaps even more promising than acute myocardial infarction is the setting of heart failure. In my opinion, that is the clinical situation in which cells will probably have the greatest impact. So the most authoritative meta-analysis in this area is published by the Cochrane group in Oxford. Their latest paper was published online in April 2014. They reviewed 23 randomized clinical trials involving more than 1,200 patients with heart failure that were treated with cell therapy. And the conclusion of this very careful analysis is that there is moderate quality evidence that cell therapy does indeed improve ejection fraction and reduces end systolic volume as well as end diastolic volume in this patient population. In addition, they found moderate quality evidence that cell therapy improves functional capacity and New York Heart Association classification. So these are important conclusions that, again, provide a more than adequate justification in my mind for pursuing studies of cell therapy in these two patient populations. Now, with regard specifically to cardiac stem cells, the data are very limited. There has been a study of c-Kit-positive cardiac stem cells, the CPO trial, which was conducted in patients with ischemic heart failure and has shown encouraging results and no adverse effects ascribable to cell therapy. There has been a study of cardiosphere-derived cell therapy, the Caduceus trial, in patients with a recent acute myocardial infarction, which suggested a reduction in infarct size and, again, no adverse effects ascribable to cell therapy. I think both of these studies provide an adequate justification for pursuing the investigation of these cell types. So I think that although we don't have conclusive evidence at the moment that cell therapy does positively affect an outcome in patients with cardiovascular disease, there is sufficient evidence to justify continuing investigation and, more importantly, moving to larger and more conclusive trials, i.e. phase 3 trials in these patients. Indeed, there are already several such phase 3 trials going on, and we, of course, are anxiously awaiting the results of these studies. Finally, we must always keep in mind that our first and foremost responsibility is to our patients. Many heart disease patients, particularly patients with heart failure, have few options and a very grim prognosis at present. Now, cell therapy offers these patients a new hope and a new option, which is not currently available, and we must try to make this option available to this large patient population. So if the trials of cell therapy produce the results that we hope they will, this will definitely and possibly dramatically improve the outcome in a large number of patients with heart disease, and certainly in that sense, cell therapy fits in the broader mission of the American Heart Association, which is to build healthier lives free of cardiovascular disease and stroke.